All right. The reading this morning is Psalm 139, 1 through 12, and 23 and 24. O Lord, you have searched me and you know me. You know when I sit and when I rise. You perceive my thoughts from afar. You discern my going out and my lying down. You are familiar with all my ways. Before a word is on my tongue, you know it completely, O Lord. You hem me in, behind and before. You have laid your hand upon me. Such knowledge is too wonderful for me, too lofty for me to attain. Where can I go from your spirit? Where can I flee from your presence? If I go up to the heavens, you are there. If I make my bed in the depths, you are there. If I rise on the wings of the dawn, if I settle on the far side of the sea, even there, your hand will guide me. Your right hand will hold me fast. If I say, surely the darkness will hide me and the light become night around me, even the darkness will not be dark to you. The night will shine like the day, for darkness is as light to you. Search me, O God, and know my heart. Test me and know my anxious thoughts. See if there is any offensive way in me, and lead me in the way everlasting. The word of the Lord.
Amen.
Thank you, Miss.
Just you and me today. Yeah. Is that okay?
Yep.
Sure. Who'd you bring today?
Sapphire.
You want to tell everybody what Sapphire is?
A dragon. Wow.
Show everybody what it is. Let's put her skirt down. Go ahead. Isn't that cute? Is that real?
No.
Oh, okay. Just check in because, you know, sometimes animals can be messy. You know that?
Yeah.
How do you know that animals can be messy?
Because my chickens are kind of messy.
Okay, your chickens are kind of messy. Yep, but can you take care of your chickens yet?
Yes.
And how do you take care of your chickens?
Give them water and give them food.
Do you play with your chickens?
No.
How come?
Because sometimes they peck me, sometimes they don't.
Sometimes they peck you. Not friendly, huh?
Yeah, they're not very
friendly. Yeah, well, anyway, this morning I want to continue our talk about seeds and growing things. So do you have anything growing at home?
Catnip and mint.
Catnip and mint. And the catnip is for you? Is that why you're growing? Oh. Who's the catnip for?
For my cat.
For your cats, okay. But what do you do with the mint?
Sometimes I eat the leaves.
You chew on the leaves? Yeah. Tastes pretty good, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, have you ever gone to Gigi's house when Juju was there and weeding her gardens for her?
Yes.
Okay. How did Juju know what to pick, what were weeds and what were flowers? Did you know what was weeds and what were flowers?
Sometimes.
Sometimes. Well, how do we tell which is which?
I don't know.
Yeah, sometimes we don't know, do we? Now, for those, I know all of you are growers of some sorts. Did you ever pull something up that you thought was a weed?
Yes. Oh, yeah.
And it was just yesterday, huh? And you discovered it wasn't really a weed?
Yeah.
Yeah. How about the opposite? Have you ever thought something was growing into something good and you let it grow and what happened? It was a weed. So sometimes we don't know the difference. And Juju pulled out what she thought were weeds because of what she knew. But sometimes even what we know isn't really the truth. That we try to pick out weeds and they're turned out to be flowers, and sometimes we think it's because something's growing real good, it might be a flower, and it turns out to be a weed. One of the biggest things that we have that people grow is the butterfly bush. You know what the butterfly bush looks like?
Yes, we only have one at our house.
You have one at your house. Very good. Anybody else have a butterfly bush? Did you know butterfly bushes are actually weeds? And they're invasive creatures in England? When my brother came to visit from England, he was shocked that I was growing a butterfly bush. And he said, "Why are you growing that weed in your yard?" Because in America, we think they're beautiful. But yet when you travel through England, they are covering all the sides of the railroad tracks. They're beautiful, but they're weeds. So sometimes even the weeds are beautiful. So we have to be careful and discern what's a weed and what's not a weed, and what's a flower and what's a flower and what's not a flower. So if we don't know, who do you think we should ask? Somebody with more experience than us. Right? Okay. Thanks. Heavenly Father, we rejoice in this day that we have so much to share, that we, oh God, have experienced your blessing, whether it's in the travel or whether it's in the gathering of friends and relatives. We thank you for each of those events and pray, oh God, that you would continue to bless us with good times. This day, oh God, we pray for Marie and Bob, who are in Dublin, Ireland. We continue to pray for their safety and for their health as they continue on in their travel. Pray for Joe and Pat DeMarie as they are away as well. We are thankful that they finally got this trip in, Lord, and we pray that you would keep them safe as well. We pray for Matt Kosak and family heading home to South Carolina today. We pray for Jack, Jordan, and John traveling to Ireland on Tuesday to visit family. We pray, oh God, for Deborah Lloyd traveling as well. We pray, oh God, for healing for Joe DeMarie for a procedure on Wednesday, for Ron Bittner with nose cancer, prayers for Joe Schnedeker undergoing surgery Thursday for a mass in his lung. We pray, oh God, for continued healing for Judy Garrison and for Viola McGuigan. Lord, many others need your healing touch, oh God, so we pray that when their need is When there is need, O God, that you would answer that need. We have unspoken requests this day, O God, that are only spoken unto you. And Lord, this day we pray for encouragement for Jennifer Cruikshank as she deals with changes in her life as well. We continue to pray for Ryan and Lynette Smith and their family as they travel to visit colleges for Ricky. We know that this time of transition is difficult for them, and we pray, O God, for their health and their safety in their travel as well. Lord, we thank you for answered prayer, a found debit card. Lord, we know what trouble that is, and we thank you that that was found. God, we continue to pray that you would be with the family of baby Jimmy, that you, oh God, would continue to give the doctors the wisdom needed to deal with that. And Lord, we thank you for his mother having a good week this week. And continued prayers, oh God, as he moves through his development. And now, God, we continue to lift up this service to you, Lord, that you, oh God, would continue to lead us and teach us, and then use us, send us forth from this place as your disciples. For we pray all of this in Jesus' name. Amen. There is always, and I mean always, an ongoing debate about the temperature in the room. For those who sit close to the air conditioner, it's always too cold. For those further away, it's always too hot. Even in colder weather, when the thermostat is set, the debate continues. Too hot, many can't sleep. Too cold, same problem. And when there are multiple people in the house, sometimes there has to be a lot of compromise or arguing. Some like it hot, and others not. Debate, compromise, bargaining, all good in our life today. But as you will see, as we look to our scripture lesson, there will come a time when you may not want it hot. Listen as we continue to look at Jesus' parable teaching from Matthew chapter 13. And this morning, beginning with verse 24, Jesus told them another parable. The kingdom of heaven is like a man who sowed good seed in his field. But while everyone was sleeping, his enemy came and sowed weeds among the wheat and went away. When the wheat sprouted and formed heads, then the weeds also appeared. The owner's servants came to him and said, "Sir, didn't you sow good seeds in your field? Where then did the weeds come from?" "An enemy did this," he replied. The servants asked him, "Do you want us to go and pull them up?" "No," he answered, "because while you are pulling the weeds, you may uproot the wheat with them. Let both grow together until the harvest. At that time, I will tell the harvesters, 'First, collect the weeds and tie them in bundles to be burned. Then gather the wheat and bring it into my barn.'" Continuing in verse 36, "When Jesus left the crowd and went into the house, his disciples came to him and said, 'Explain to us the parable of the weeds in the field.' Jesus answered, 'The one who sowed the good seeds is the Son of Man. The field is the world, and the good seed stands for the people of the kingdom. The weeds are the people of the evil one, and the enemy who sows them is the devil. The harvest is the end of the age, and the harvesters are angels. As the weeds are pulled up and burned in the fire, so it will be at the end of the age. The Son of Man will send out his angels, and they will weed out of his kingdom everything that causes sin and all who do evil. They will throw them into the blazing furnace, where there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. Then the righteous will shine like the sun in the kingdom of their Father. Whoever has ears, let them hear." May we be enlightened by these words this morning. We continue to see Jesus using symbols and parables. He talks about farming because he knows that the community will understand. And even though we're not great farmers like they were, we all plant things. All farmers know how weeds can take over crops, even when they don't plant them. Even when they use the best seed available, sometimes they get weeds. We can all testify to that, as well as even our small flower beds grow weeds overnight, especially if we use free mulch. You never know what's going to grow. My flower beds have been tended and mulched, and I always welcome some of the strangest weeds. Maybe I don't really welcome them, but it's interesting nonetheless. In this parable, when the servant notices the weeds, he asks the owner if he should pull up the weeds, and the answer surprises him, for he's told no. "Don't pull up the weeds now, because if you pull up the weeds, you may also pull up wheat. Wait for the harvest, and then they will be separated." That's where we really need to pay attention. For I know that my first instinct is to pull the weeds immediately. But Jesus isn't talking about those green growing plants, is he? When the disciples ask for an explanation, they come to an understanding of what Jesus is trying to tell them. And that is what we need to hear as well. the reality in our world is that there is good and there is bad side by side. And that's not going to change until Christ comes again. We can try to make sure that all our friends and family, even our acquaintances, are the good in our world. You know, people of good character, people of good morals, of healthy lifestyles, people who have a positive attitude on life, people who are kind, who are helpful, people who care about others and all of God's creation as well. Wouldn't that be just perfect? Is that how all your friends are? Is that how all your families are at all times? The truth is, we live in an imperfect world. And try as we do, we will run into evil even when we don't expect it. For we know from the lesson that the devil has thrown in weeds to try to uproot God's people. Now let's be honest. Sometimes when we're gardening and something we don't recognize appears, we don't always know if it's a weed. And I know I am not the only one. Sometimes we let it grow and find out it's a gift from a bird. It could be a beautiful flower, or in my case, I get tomato plants.
Oh.
I don't know where they're eating tomatoes, but it wasn't from my house. Sometimes when we let it grow, it's a good plant. Sometimes when we let it grow, it's a wonderful looking weed. But we would never know unless we let it grow. Sometimes when we meet people, we prejudge them. Okay, again, let's be honest. We always prejudge people, don't we? We make a decision whether it's someone we want to get to know or not. And sometimes when we get to know them better, they turn out to be good friends. And then there are times when we get to know them and we also know that they're not the kind of person that we should get to know better. If we are too quick to judge, however, we could miss out on something good. But if we do not do any evaluation at all, if we do not judge, then we can become strangled by someone that stops our growth altogether. It's such a fine line, isn't it? Judge too soon, we miss out. Judge too late, we could be destroyed. So, what's the answer? Knowledge. Knowledge is power, and I don't mean our own power, but a power that only God can give us. We as people of faith are told that we should be in prayer about everything. Every day, all day, not just on Sundays. Not just in trouble, not just when we want or we need something. Have you ever prayed for discernment? The power to know what is best to do in a situation? Especially when you meet new people, do you pray on that meeting? So that God will help you determine if that person is right for you. Now, I know that many people have prayed for a life partner, for the right spouse. And those of you that have lasted many, many years, I know you prayed pretty hard and got what you asked for. But yet, my guess is sometimes we didn't pray hard enough and we ended up with the wrong person. We need to do just that. We continue to pray to develop our relationship with God so that God can guide us in the right direction. We need to protect our personal lives so that we can ensure that we do what God wants us to do. Many of us want to fix other people, and we may even pray for that to happen. But believe me, if it is not something that God has ordained, you are wasting your time. If we truly believe that we have surrendered our lives unto God, we need to remember God wants all parts of us. Being a Christian is not the easiest thing to do, for it is so different than the world we are living in today. All the more reason we should try to have that close relationship with God. For the evil one has done an excellent job of scattering seeds of tough weeds in our world. And when the end comes, when God sends his angels into the world, I know that I, for one, do not like it hot. I do not want to be counted as a weed who has strangled the life out of one of God's people. I don't want to be bunched together and thrown into the fire to be destroyed. It is only by remaining close to our Creator that I can become strong against those weeds. And when the time comes, I will be recognized as one of God's own and not be looked at as a weed. Some like it hot, but I'm not one of them. How about you? Amen. My prayer for all of us today is that we know that we are the good seeds that God has planted. But let us all be aware that the evil one has put weeds among us. Stay close to God. Use God's strength as you move forward in your life. I don't like it hot. I hope you don't like it hot either. Because when the end comes, I don't want to be in the fire. May we all be those that are called children of God when God separates the good from the bad. Amen. Thank you.